Welcome here to Hampton, Georgia for round number 3 of the Core Xfinity Series. We are here at the Atlanta Motor Speedway here. Third race of the season, still pretty early in the season, obviously. And a lot of these guys really want to get that early season win. And what better place to do it than try to do it here in Atlanta? Really fast paced and fun track to race at. The 20 of Jacob Hall still start on the pole. Roger James, hometown kid, he'll start to the outside in that 10. Let's get you down to track side for the race commands.
Driver, start your engine!
Crank it up, fired up, didn't need anything.
There it is, engines fired up, drivers running off of pit road. And it looks like everyone will get going here. So, it's been interesting. First two races so far, we had a race out there at Daytona, Tyson Gifford winning, and then we had a Daytona road course, was Cody Goforth capturing the win there. Here in Atlanta today, for a lot of these guys, it's their first normal race of the season, so it should be interesting to see how things all play out. There's Collins in 61, he's hoping for better luck this race after having some problems out there. Daytona road course, and speaking of Daytona road course, there's the race winner, 72, Cody Goforth, Amy Fisher in the 9, taking over from his little brother who drove that car last season, hometown driver as well. We'll be keeping an eye on him. But here we go, pace car off pit or off down the pit road. It's Jacob Hulse in 20, captured the pole. He'll lead us to green. We're green and racing here in Atlanta. Halts, clears out of 2 on the backstretch for the first time at full speed. They're going to go 4 wide for second. Roger James, he gets pushed to the outside. Cameron Hathaway, what a move. 4 wide on lap 1. Going to be led by the 20, but they're still 4 wide. Going to keep an eye on these guys right here. Cameron Hathaway with a big move as he's going to get into the apron just a little bit. Will anyone give in? Roger James, he gets into the wall. Oh, careful, careful. Man, these guys are squeezing real tight right there. Contact between the 4 and the 19, or the 26, rather. Car way down there. That's Zane Davidson in the 92. Comes back up on the track. No issues right there. Now they're back to 2 wide and 3 wide. For the time being, Jacob Hulse clears, and he's going to come around and lead the second lap as well. Still looking for his first win here in the Core Xfinity Series. Oh man, these guys are all over the place in mid-pack as well. Atlanta, it's a wide-open track, really fast pace. The race is almost like a super speedway until the tires start to get the best of the cars. And as you can see, the 98 Alexander Rowe, he really drove it into the corner that time right there. As he makes it 3 wide, Zane Davidson in the middle, but Boston Jones in that super right there, 26 to the inside of the 20. Jacob Hulse, how about Cameron Hathaway in the middle? Halsey's going to get a big run on the outside. Christian Russell to the inside in the 12. Remember, he won this race in the playoffs last season. Trying to do it again here today. He's going to make it 3 wide for the race lead. Jones to the middle. Alexander Rowe right there in the 98 behind him. Collins as well in the 61. They're 3 wide for the race lead. Leading at the line this time is going to be the 20 again. Guys are still 3x3 for the most part here in the top 10. These guys sliding all over the place. Thing is, though, you don't want to slide too much because Atlanta eats up your tires. One car in the wall way back there. Trying to board with Cameron Hathaway.
3 wide top.
Roger James right there behind him. 21 Bafot Sako, winner of this race last season. Earlier in the season last season. As they're going to go 4 wide once again. Ale Masco in that 31 making moves. He goes up the track a little bit. That's going to run the 21 up the track. And it's amazing how these guys haven't made much contact with each other. They're sliding and slipping everywhere on the track. Fisher, he fell way back there along with Zane Davidson. Everyone sliding all over the place, getting into the wall, trying to collect their cars back together. Christian Russell pouncing at the race lead once again. I believe he will lead that time. There will be pit stops. Two pit stops should be made here, so question is when. I suspect another 5 to 8 laps, somewhere around that time, as continue to go side by side for the race lead. In the back, though, they're mostly single file. Jacob Hulse, really good run on the outside of Christian Russell. Remember, this is the race that Hulse started his first Xfinity start, finished 5th. So it's no surprise to see that he got the pole. He's been fast all race weekend. Now in that 20 car, guys, and as well as Christian Russell, this track is a lot of history between Christian and this track. Remember the ARCA race, really bad crash, and had a leg injury in that race, but he fears nothing here at the Atlanta Motor Speedway. He's to the inside, getting a big push by Alexander Rowe, and then you have Nathan Orman, who's in this 16 today, winning the truck race. The guys back here, all racing each other. Chase Abbott, Winnie Calhoun. Noah Gutierrez is back here. Zachary DeLello, I'm surprised he's back here in the 22. He's one of the drivers you expect to really be running up front. Former ARCA Series champion, and he's been doing really good in the upper series, but it's still a long way to go here at Atlanta, so sure there's nothing to worry about. Luke Martin hanging out in the back of this huge lead pack, as these guys still racing like it's the first 2-3 laps, and they're still drag racing for the lead. Russell, and oh, look at the big run. Vali Moscow gets to the outside of the 16 of Nathan Orman. What a big thing it would be if Orman can win this race and go back to back for a weekend sweep. And still, these two are side by side, most everyone up here not giving an inch. When will the tire wear kick in is a big question. Austin Jones in that 26, he's trying to make that midline work, but he slides up so much and loses a ton of momentum of corner exits. So he gets to see him stuck in the middle of that white super right there. And finally, the 20, or he's trying to clear the 12, but Christian Russell not giving up on an inside line, trying to make it work. And it's just not happening. Hulse, really fast race car right now. Trying to clear, oh, a little bit of bump right there, I believe. The 28 and 1 at Allison Rain. Had a bit of contact right there with the 28. Big run by Valdemasco down the backstretch again on the outside. He has Bafold Sokol behind him. And the 11 is right there, Greg Lee to the outside as well. Big run right here by Vale Masco. Another driver who's been with us for a while, looking for that first win.
Still there inside.
He's right up here with these guys racing. Oh man, someone below in the 28. Really sideways in the corner. Chris Main. Main has one win here next to the series, looking for another here today as a 20. And they're coming out of pit road this time. You heard it right there. Pit stops. Green flag pit stops starting here in Atlanta. Led by the 20 of Jacob Hulse. He leads them down pit road. Christian Russell behind him. 61, 21, 92. Zane Davidson, I know he's one of those drivers that's just looking for a much better race than last. The last two races, he has wrecked out. Cody Goforth.
Come around and pit this time. I want you to come around and pit this time. Be careful getting on the pit road down there.
And there you go. Goforth. He's going to come down now and lead the rest of these guys down pit road. Will anyone stay out? Austin Jones, he's real low right there. Remember, the rule says you have to stay on the outside. Oh, careful. Don't check up right there. The 19 coming in hot, as well as the 36. This guy's nearly making contact. Don't want any damage here. There'll be more time on pit road, and of course, a slower race car. Four tires, it looks like it is.
Small piece of tape I put on the left-hand side of the grill. I want to cover up 3 inches on the left-hand side there.
Four tires and some tape for the 72 of Cody Goforth. Cameron Hathaway, he's right there behind him. Fisher is there as well. Fisher would love to get another Atlanta win.
Go.
Goforth, he's out. The four is out. Race off of pit road. Hopefully no one gets into any trouble. There's Roger James. Oh man, Boston Jones did not have a good pit stop, it looks like, in that 26. Real slow. And the question now is, where's the race leader? Who's going to be the race leader? Maybe these two drivers right here. Yeah, Christian Russell and Bafo Tsako. They come out as your race leader. I believe they will. But even so, still one more pit stop to be made. Christian Russell, he leads at the line. Bafo Tsako in the hunt. Both former winners here in Atlanta. Both looking for another win. I wouldn't count on anyone else as well. How about the 72 of Cody Goforth back there in third? And then the 92 of Zane Davidson, I believe he's also back there. I believe that's him in fourth. The Fosako staying in that slipstream. Now the tricky thing is trying to pass here is you can get a real good run going into the corners, but on the exit of the corners, that outside lane is going to prevail. Man, what happened to the 20? They did not have a good pit stop. Jacob Hall, something. Not sure where he is. They did not have a good pit stop. Hearing there's a problem with the left rear tire changer. And that's another race where we see the pit crews having some issues on one of the fastest cars. One of the faster cars, as here comes for the race lead, Bafo Tsako into 21 to the inside of Russell, and there's the run I was talking about on the outside. Russell's going to be right there behind him as they drag race, and well, while that's happening, that's going to allow Cody Goforth and Zane Davidson and all those other guys to gain some big grounds on them as they continue to drag race. Russell not giving up on the outside. Two veterans here of the series dueling it out. Mano y mano. Now, if that 21 could just clear him, maybe he'll try and get away. I don't see any lap traffic anytime soon. And he clears. Race leader, Fosako into 21. I don't think Russell's going to give up, though. The next lapper just crossed the start-finish line. Plenty of time for these guys to race. And Russell, he's already peaking. 21 holds the lead. There's Chris Mayne, Zane Davidson, all these other guys back here battling. Cameron Hathaway, Collins. All these other guys back here having a solid run. Greg Lee. There's Jacob Halts right there. We just saw him. And a bunch of other guys doing battle side by side. A caution-free race so far, much like last season. Will we go the whole way caution-free, though? The Toyota is back here. Jones in 26, man, I don't know what happened, but their car is just completely lost pace. I don't know if they got into the wall or what happened. They looked like they were fast in the early run, but they kind of lost the pace just a little bit. Shavis Mitchell and others back there battling. Still, side by side, Russell on the attack on Bafo Tsako, trying to get that race lead, and it's not helping their cause at all, because the guys behind them, Chris Mayne, Collins, all those guys are catching.
Start eyeing up the pit entry off of 4, yellow line, orange cone.
Still, side by side, drag racing. They've been like this for the last 2-3 laps. Neither driver wants to give an inch, because they know if you can be the leader entering pit road, it gives you a better chance of being a leader exiting pit road. It's just up to the pit crew, really, to do their job and get it done right. There's Nathan Norman, truck race winner here, battling with Raymond Fisher side by side. And there's Bahals right here. He's racing with the one of Allison Rain and Vale Masco for top 15. And these other four guys up here, Alexander Rowe and others, and these guys all back here, they need to stay single file, really, not race too much and try to catch these guys, who, by the way, are still side by side. Russell, Tsako, side by side for the last 4 laps now, and Russell, I think he's finally going to clear him there. Tsako may be getting another run on the outside. He will. Russell cannot clear with 10 laps to go. Or a little less than 10 laps here coming to the start-finish line. Someone needs to clear somebody because those guys behind are catching. Sacco's still on the outside. Less than a second and a half separates second from third. It's Chris Mayne. He's trying to keep those guys behind him and then maybe catch these two. And he's trying to, he's gunning for his second career winners. But Folt Sacco on the outside again. He too, I believe, is looking for his second win here in the Core Xfinity Series. Russell looking for his fifth. As they're still drag racing, though, this is not helping them. And with here, pit stops looming.
Don't drag race.
Yeah, right there. They're saying, his spotter saying, don't drag race, but kind of a tough position because you don't want to give it a position and then, you know, pit stops right around the corner. You don't want to give up that position. Oh, look at the seven. Big run on the outside, but he's going to get into the wall. Jordan Whaley right there for Ryzer Motorsports gets into the wall. He had a whale of a run. No pun intended right there, but these guys, we should be, man, these guys are still side by side. I don't know how they're doing that.
This time, come this time.
And looks like they're going to be pitting this time. Russell may come in before the 21. He has the inside line. Ooh, Russell slipped up just a little bit right there. The 21 is going to get the run on the outside now. These guys putting on one heck of a show. To us, it's fun to watch, but it's got to be frustrating for both those guys. It's mainly, I believe, he's going to stay out. Russell, he's going to duck low and come down pit road. The 21 is as well. As Chris Mayne, Cody Goforth, both drivers stay out. Goforth looking for two straight wins here in the Core Xfinity Series and trying to win for the third straight week. The Haltz is down pit road. We saw Derek Green in the 17. Or no, there he is. Right there. I thought he was one of the guys going down pit road. And I'm assuming everyone else is going to on that pit road too. It's up to the pit crews now to execute and get their driver back out on track as quickly as possible. We should be seeing two tires. That would be my call at least. A couple guys already getting out of pit road. Collins, he's out. Now we have to know where the 12 and 21 are.
We're
hearing someone, the drag man for Christian Russell, having issues. Another pit crew problem here. They're out now, but we had a little issue on the 12. Roger James, he's in. He's not having the day he was hoping for here in his hometown Atlanta. There's Cody Goforth. He's out. He beats Cameron Hathaway and Chris Mayne. Greg Lee is out as well. As well as Michael DeClan in the 39. There's the 21 of Folt Sacco. And there's the 12 of Christian Russell. They had a little bit of mishap on pit road, but it didn't cost them. Well, it actually cost them a lot of time. And
there you go, man. Keep taking nice
with about four coming to three laps to go, that was a costly mistake for Russell's pit crew. Folt Sacco looking to go back-to-back here in Atlanta. Won this race last season, remember. 92. He's right there with the 72. That's Zane Davidson and Cody Goforth, and then everyone else, mostly single file. One car going out pit road, Borislav Konstantinovich. So it looks like we might just go all the way with without a yellow. It's Christian Russell in the 12, currently leads right now. Here's Allison Rain scored as the leader last time, but that's going to change once they cross the start and finish line here. And clearly, as you can see, way out front, it's the 21 of Folt Sacco.
Time to shake and bake.
Only one win here in the Core Xfinity Series, and it was here at Atlanta last season. Trying to do it again and put their name on the board and make the playoffs once again. This was last season, beating on Nathan Fisher, the hometown driver. This race went green all the way, and in the end, it was Folt Sacco capturing the win. Folt trying to do it again here today. Pretty big lead on Christian Russell. Russell, that pit stop is what probably just lost them this race, and we've just been seeing a lot of mistakes lately on pit road. 72, he's put under pressure now on Zane Davidson. Cody Goforth trying to get there. He's going to push him up the track just a little bit. But here, White flag. White flag is out, but just heard the radio right there. That was from your race leader in the 21. Go for it. He finally gets by Zane Davidson. Now has his eyes set on the 61. But of course, oh, the 21. The 21 on the apron. Your race leader. The 21, we're hearing having tire issues. A tire down for the 21. And Christian Russell in the 12. He's going to win it. Christian Russell wins it at Atlanta. Oh my goodness. A tire issue for the 21 of Bafode Sakos. They completely shredded the tire out of the exit of 4. Or out of the exit of 2, rather. And Christian Russell, with the upset, he's going to steal the win. Wow. That's his second straight win here at Atlanta. Because remember, he won the playoff race here last season. Here it is, out of 4. Oh man, that tough break right there for Bafode Sakho. You see the left front just completely shreds. And remember, they only took right side tires during that pit stop. What a heartbreak for Bafode Sakho on their way to their second win here at Atlanta. Collins, he gets second. Cody Goforth third. Zane Davidson fourth. And Chris Mayne fifth. Greg Lee, Cameron Hathaway, Jacob Halls, Valiamasco, and Whaley, he's going to get a top 10. Great run for them. There's Bafode Sakho. He's currently scored in the 25th position. Oh, and Henley in the 8 also had an issue with tire. But wow, that was unexpected. And Christian Russell, 5th career win.
Excellent, boys. Awesome job on pit road. Awesome driver. Good job with the pit strategy here. We gotta do this!
Nice work, guys. Wow!
Dominant effort. Awesome shot.
Hell yeah! Woo!
This is a prime example of why you never give up. After making that mistake on pit road with the Jackman right there, it still pays off with the 12, well, with the 21 having a tire issue, and you just never give up. Even when things are looking as bad as they seem. Russell, I know that he wasn't going to win this race right there, especially how far back he was, but wow, Christian Russell is a winner here once again at Atlanta, and him and the history of this place looks like it's going to continue. But congratulations to Christian Russell on the race win. I get you down to victory lane here. Thank you guys for watching. It's going to be the Cup guys' turn to take on here the Atlanta Motor Speedway. Should be a fun one to watch those Cup guys. But in the meantime, we'll see you at the Dodge Raceway Stadium.